giving me the opportunity to do a little bit of a review of farm and food care and our activities this last year. And I did want to say right off the start, for the first time ever, farm and food care has 400 individuals who have registered. And I did download a little bit of an applause app on my phone, so we can have some live audience feel to this. So it's great to see that we have such a strong level of support here from people who are interested about food. I did want to draw your attention just to a few things on the app. Under the resources section, there's either additional resources on your mobile app, or if you're on the desktop version, it's just says resources. You'll see that there are polls. We ask that at some point in time, you just take the opportunity to go through and see those polls and just put your answers in there, and we'll provide some results of that hopefully later on. The other thing to be more interactive with this, we do have door prizes, believe it or not. And there's four different ways that you can actually enter. One is, if you're on the mobile app, just post a picture, something regarding food or agriculture, and we will randomly draw one of you to receive one of the door prizes. As well, when you're under that resource section, you'll see a leaderboard. So this is the person who ends up posting the most in terms of pictures or asking questions or being part of the polls. You get points under Whova. So whoever leads that at the end of the conference will also get a door prize. One lucky participant who lives in either Saskatoon or Regina will be given sometime here in the early part of the conference, Skip the Dishes gift card for you to get some coffee or some donuts partway through as well. So if you are that lucky participant, please post online the selection that you took. As well, we'll have eight random participants who will be selected to receive Professor Caulfield's new book, Relax, Damn It, A User's Guide to the Age of Anxiety, which I'm looking forward to reading myself. If you do have any questions under the agenda, you'll see the sessions. You can post them directly to the session that we're in, and we will get to them in the question and answer sessions as we go. As Henry mentioned, 2020 obviously for everybody has been a little bit of a change of everyday living for all of us, and farm and food care is no different than the way you've had to change as well. So we've really changed the way we're doing things, and I think if I could draw a little bit of an analogy, we're from the province of Saskatchewan, we love our football, we effectively had to call an audible. And what I mean by that, we switched to be more online. So gone are the times this last year where we could have our in-person events. We had scheduled Agriculture in the City that usually brings around 4,000 people into the Lawson Heights Mall, gives them an opportunity to talk to farmers, ranchers, from everything from the animals to sea, all the way up to the careers that kids can have or youth can have in the agriculture profession. And it's a great opportunity that we just couldn't do this past year as well. We were going to have a breakfast at the barn event at the Rainier Dairy Center at the University of Saskatchewan. This again is postponed at least until 2021. And we look forward to doing that as well. We typically do have a lot of tours. Those had to be canceled, whether it's food influencers or students at the University of Saskatchewan or Saskatchewan Polytechnic. We're hopeful in 2021 we can get back to those tours again with those individuals. So just so you know as well, an audible means when you go to the line of scrimmage, you're a quarterback, you look at the defense and you think, you know what, this plan is not going to work that I called, so boom, we got to change it. We have to switch what we're doing. And really, like I said, we switch to online engagement with consumers. We focused a lot of our activities through Canadian Food Focus. And as a result of that, we used resources like Farm and Food or Farm Food 360 and the Real Dirt on Farming, which are resources that were developed by Farm and Food Care Ontario and partnered with Saskatchewan. We use those as much as we could for teaching resources with teachers or parents who are at home with their children. We also answered questions that consumers legitimately had about why their grocery store shelves were bare of certain foods. We explained to them the logistics system of the food industry, how live animals cannot change again at the snap of a finger, and the really extensive distribution system that exists. We also implemented new strategies to help Canadians navigate and understand how food in this great country actually is grown from coast to coast. Not only things in here in Saskatchewan, but mushroom farms in Ontario and horticulture farms throughout this country. And really our numbers are nothing less than unbelievable, really. We have reached 9 million Canadians since our launch in the spring of 2019. Majority of those people who were reached are just from March onwards. And not only that, not only are we reaching a large level of Canadians, we're reaching a strong level of the urban audience that we need to have these conversations with. So it really is excellent that we're able to do this, and we're looking forward to doing this more in the future. This kind of leads to our offensive line. And we have a great team with Farm and Food Care, Dorothy Long handling the communications, Penny Eaton, who does our managing of our programs, Angela Larson, who specializes in social media and analytics, Julie Kenyon handles social media and analytics, Angela Larson specializing in digital media and communications, and Shauna Hill, who looks after all of our finances. Really, we've seen from these last few months that we're really a successful team. We've got extra points, and we're looking forward to the future. In fact, if I could use maybe the New England Patriots of the last decade, we want to be the franchise team when it comes to building trust, not only in Saskatchewan, but for the rest of the country as well. Some opportunities that are coming up, we are going to be moving Speak Up training. So if you have had the opportunity to take our Speak Up training across the country from the Farm and Food Care Ontario or Saskatchewan, this will be an opportunity to have individual Speak Up training online through a 5-module course. We finished the modules. We're just going through the taping of that right now. And really what this does is allows you to have more meaningful engagement conversations with consumers and gives you a better understanding of what consumers are thinking. The other thing that's going to be coming up in 2021 is a speaker series. This is going to be in conjunction with Farm and Food Care Ontario and Farm and Food Care Prince Edward Island, where we can have some engaging dialogue and discussion on some hot button topics that are coming up. So with that, we do have a video that's prepared here, and I will ask that Logan takes over that video right now.